was the guy who got me into music, playing music. And we later on went to make a band called Minuteman. I'm from Virginia, but I came when I was 10. My father was a sailor. He had to move from the Navy House into the projects, and that's where I met D. Boone, was in the projects. And this is the early 70s, so not a lot of guns, but some fighting and shit. So his ma wanted us in the house after school so we wouldn't get in trouble. It wasn't like she thought we were going to make a career out of music. She said, "You're going to play bass." I didn't really know what a fucking bass was. You know, arena rock, we were so far away, it looked like a guitar. She said, "Every band's got a fucking bass." So we would stay in the house and be just jamming. Her idea was to keep us out of trouble. We did it because we wanted to be with each other, you know. When I was first playing and stuff, just wanted to be with D. Boone, you know, and that was a way we could spend time playing and stuff. But for me, yeah, the music was a personal thing. And then we found a scene where we could do it for other people. I was 16 when I saw a real bass and I got one. A little later. At first I saw one in the store and I fucking couldn't believe it. I remember when me and D. Boone saw our first show. There's a guy here who played drums in the Weirdos. He's actually from Pedro. And he was telling us about this scene where people wrote their own songs. He's wearing a Kotex around his neck. His name's Nicky Beat. And so we went and saw this gig, and the first thing I said to D. Boone was, "Man, we can do this." The first thing that punk did to us was like, you can write your own songs. You know, we never did that. The culture in those days was copying records. Everybody copied records. It was bullshit. And you could tell they were just starting to learn how to play. We really liked that nerve. Thinking there's some solitude and staring off at the furthest view, while closer up the assault begins, the castle that's a bird starts hammering. In the old days, we were the only punk rockers in the town. You know, before there was a music scene called that, punk's a guy who gets f***ed in jail for cigarettes. It was f***ed up. You know, when the movement started, we painted on our own clothes and did that stuff like we saw in England. And man, people gave us so much f***ing shit and hell that after a year or two of that, we went back to our high school clothes. And we thought we'd just keep the punk part in our head. It's kind of difficult. I do this all the time, so I don't even have to. I just come in and sit down and she cooks it up. See the hole in the wall? Yeah. Breakwater? That's what I'm gonna fucking paddle through. Again, feeling less than a man. Using a cloak to hide what's missing. The look on the face, baka. Knife in the scabbard, waddle about. Feathers in the back, sticking out. No hands for the knife, only feet to wander. And a head to wonder. What a blunder. What a fucked up thing it is. In the garden, green serene. A crown of two cherries, gently perched, interestingly. Passion put there, and born of dreams, carved that way. Passion painted, reason fainted, no, swooned. Balanced, unbalanced, swirling, sloshing, head spun. Swirling and sloshing, jumping on tears, loss and liberation, loss and liberation, forever the connection, forever the question, be brave, what? Stop never reflecting. The lesson ain't ever less than. The lesson never lessens. Now here's the deal. Here's the seal. Here's exactly where to kneel. The truth that got bought was fraught with a reality much too real. That's a good point, but what's the point? To finger someone or to warn? Look what's your way, coming our way, and packing a backhand of harm. We saw a lot of desperate situations. We saw people who would move up there, you know, and then end up. I remember the worst thing. I ain't going to say the name of the band or the guy, but man, remember when all those dudes used to hook on Santa Monica Boulevard? I saw a guy from a band out there. I was thinking, fuck, man, you know, as things come this desperate. We had to make a life too, Cash, you know. Like the Minutemen worked during the daytime the whole time. It was hard to make a living off of. We were starting to. And we lived very econo. We were starting to, but he got killed before we really could. That was my worst time of my life. It was when D. Boone got killed. When D. Boone got killed, man, I really didn't think anybody wanted to hear me play bass, you know, without him. And so I stopped playing. That's what the first opera's about. I couldn't even write about the shit for 14 years. I finally got the nerve up to do that. That really hurt me. I dedicate all my records to him. I think about him all the time. I ask him stuff all the time, but yeah, he can't really, he doesn't answer me back. You know, he wants me to think about it. But I don't know what to do about that. It happens to a lot of people. A lot of people, probably all of us lose somebody, right? But I kept going, and, you know, people helped me. But, yeah, that's a weird thing. The hammer blows, the hammer blows. The castle bird's arm throws and throws while moving its walls with creature feet. Near and near without retreat, must resolve, you get the clue, you met the enemy, guess who, it's you. Many men make up the man, a painter in the painter's hand, I'll never truly understand. Dances your faces.